What's up, kings and queens? Welcome back to my channel. Today, I'm going to be doing another video, kind of like the one that I did where I told you guys I'm trilingual. Kind of like that one, and I said some phrases, but this time it's a lot more, and this time it's one language. I'm doing Espanol, or as you Americans know it, Spanish. So I'm doing three columns. When I say that, I mean I have three different subjects I'm talking about Spanish. So saying. So I'm doing greetings in Espanol, questions in Espanol, and the answers to the questions. I have 6 greetings, 7 7 questions, and 9 answers, because they're not all the same. So, hopefully this video is not too long, but hopefully it's good. So let's get into the video. So first things first, I'm going to start with what you normally say. The first one of greetings is buenos dias, and I'll put it down here how to spell it. Buenos dias means good morning. So like when you wake up in the morning and go, like if you're Hispanic and you wake up in the morning, you say buenos dias mama, if you're talking to your mom, buenos dias papa, or buenos dias abuelita, abuela. Like, you know, you say good morning to your family members or whatever. The second one is adios. And it's right here. Adios means goodbye. There's not much explaining to do with that. You just, like, you know, go get home from school. Adios, or adios, chica. Like, you just, you know, say goodbye. Hola, obviously, means hello. It's right here. It's spelled H-O-L-A. It's like you don't say the H. You say the O-L. Hola. It doesn't, like, normally in... with a phrase that has an H in it, you don't hear the H, you hear the next letter, because that's just how you speak. Or like if you're using a J, it's pronounced as an H. Like jueves, that means Thursday. Not to get off topic, but it means Thursday, and it's not used with the H, just to be using an example. Next one is buenas tardes. I have like a little different. The next one is buenas tardes. Next one is buenos tardes, which means good afternoon. So, yeah, buenos tardes. It's kind of happening right now, so you know. Next one is buenas noches. It means good night. So you know when you say you know when you're about to go to sleep, good night, or well, not good night. You would say buenas noches. My sixth one is for greetings and farewells is muy bueno, which means, muy bueno, like everything I just said, like buenas noches, buenas tardes, or buenos dias, like they all, muy bueno means all of those. So if you just want to say muy bueno instead of saying one of those, you could, that's the option. Muy bueno is right here. The questions are ¿cómo estás? ¿Cómo estás is really easy. I mean, my preference, I would say. It just means how are you, or how are you, like, yeah, basically means how are you. And that one, I would say that you would say to your friends and family, but if you're going, like, to a fancy party and it's only Hispanic people or Puerto Ricans or Mexicans or whatever, you would say ¿cómo estás? Usted, which means the same exact thing, but it's just more formal. It's just more of the I don't know how to explain it. It's something that you would say, like, if you were talking to a person you just met or a famous person, that's what you would say. You wouldn't just say ¿cómo estás? Because that's, you know, you need to be more formal. Guys should understand what I mean by that. But ¿cómo estás? Down here. And como estás, you said. So the next one, I'm just looking at my list because I put them down. The next one is ¿Cómo te va? And the next two, like ¿Cómo te va? And the next one, they mean the exact same thing technically as ¿Cómo estás? Or ¿Cómo estás? Or ¿Cómo está usted? Because it's just like if you go to Spain, they will definitely say it a different way. You go to Mexico, they'll say it a different way. It's like it's the different types of ways. So ¿Cómo te ve? ¿Cómo te va? Sorry, ¿Cómo te va? Means how's it going? So kind of like, you know, how are you? How's it going? No further explaining. There doesn't need further explaining. Next one is ¿Cómo has ido? Wait. I was saying ¿Cómo has ido? So that means how have you been? Kind of like what's like kind of like how's it going or how are you? Like I said, they're basically all similar. The next one is ¿Qué tal? Which means what's up in Spanish. So like if you walk up to a person, if you're in like Puerto Rico, you would say ¿Qué tal? Or you know, ¿Cómo estás? Like you, that one's kind of similar to ¿Cómo estás? ¿Cómo te va? And ¿Cómo has ido? Because it technically means the same thing, like kind of like you're asking the same question. Because if you're asking what's up, they're like, you know, nothing, like, you know what I mean. So it's right here. Then the next one is ¿Qué pasa? Which is, I realize that I really heard a lot. So ¿Qué pasa? Means what's happening. So basically, all of the questions are similar. I forgot that they're all similar. Basically, they're all similar. Oh wait, ¿Qué pasa? It's just like I said. It just means It means what's happening. Kind of like what's up. No, I don't need any further explaining because you guys understand. The last one, the seventh one is ¿Qué haces? Which means what are you doing? Which is a little different. So like it means like if someone says ¿Qué haces? And they say what are you doing? And in English, well, if I'm not gonna say it in Spanish, but I would say it, I'm gonna say it in English so you guys understand. It would mean like you would say, oh, I'm reading a book, or like you know what I mean, like something like that. But in Espanol, obviously, well, Spanish in Spanish. These are the answers that I have. One of the answer, so if you were really paying attention to the, that's why this is like something that you want to pay attention to, like if the questions that I just said, the answers basically go with the questions, so you know what I mean, it's with the answers to the questions. So the first one is but some of them are just random. So the first one is buen, gracias. It's right here, which means, it means well, thanks, like you're saying, I'm well, thank you for asking. The next one is muy bien, which is heard a lot, which means very well, and it's right here. Now, I've heard that a lot of people don't understand muy. A lot of people think it could be spelled with an O, like, you know, the way it sounds, it kind of trips people off. So it's spelled like right here, M-U-Y, muy, M-U-Y. Next one is como siempre, which means as always, which means like if you're asking, are you well, you would say sí, como siempre, which means yes, as always. The next one, this one is a little more tricky. This one and the next one are a little more tricky, so this one means un poco cansades, which means I'm like a little tired, but that is the way women would say it. So if you are a lady or if you are a girl and you were in you know, speaking Spanish, you would, and you were saying you wanted to say I'm tired, you would say un poco cansadas, because you are cansada, because you are a girl. If you were a male, you would say un poco cansado, which means just basically, for ladies, there's an A at the end of cansada, and there's an O at the end for males, cansado. So it's right here, and I'll put cansada and cansado, so it's not confusing. The next one is estoy enfermada, which means I'm sick, but like the first one, estoy enfermada is for women and estoy enfermado is for males. So put that right here. It's just the way it normally is. Some things are said for women and some things are said for males, even if they mean the same exact thing, but it's just the tradition and the way you have to say it. Because if you say it like a male and you're a woman, I guess it won't be read as the same thing, you know? It might be said as you're saying it different. The next one is más o menos, which means okay slash so-so. So, okay, I don't know how to explain it. So, you're saying you're okay, but so-so means the same thing. So, like, if you were saying, I'm so-so, I'm okay, but I'm not okay. Like, that's what okay means. Okay means I'm not great, but I'm not terrible. So-so means, like, if you're answering a question, you're like, I don't know, so-so. That's what it means. You guys should know that. I don't even know why I just did explain like you guys didn't even know that. But that's what it means. The eighth one, no, this is not the eighth one. The next one is mal, which means bad. Spell like this. If you guys watch Descendants, spelled the same way. Mal, you know, in Descendants, M-A-L, mal, but it's said different. And that's actually, not to get off topic, but I'm just saying, it's actually pretty cool because in Descendants, mal is supposed to be like a bad person and mal means bad. So that's actually really cool how they put it like that. But she was only named Mal because Maleficent, like M-A-L is the first letters. So, excuse me, but not to get off topic, but I did have to think about that for a second. The next one is todo bien, which means it's right here. And it's spelled, it means all good. So in Spanish, I'm not done with the list, but in Spanish, there's a lot of words that, so if I was to went up to someone and that was not Spanish at all, didn't speak anything, then, you know, that did not speak any type of Spanish, and I said, how do you think you spell todo? Now, a lot of people would say, because it sounds like I'm saying TH, it sounds like I'm saying todo, but that's technically what I'm saying, but that's not how you say it. It doesn't mean todo, like, it's not spelled T-O-T-H-O, it's like right here, it's spelled T-O-D-O, todo. It's like, you're kind of saying the D. If you can listen really clearly, you can hear it, todo, like, you can hear it, you just have to, you know, and that's just a word that trips people off a lot. It's a lot of with the T, and like with the T's in the words, it's a little easy, or with the when, like you hear the W, but it's not a W, or bien, it's really different, but it's just our culture. The last one, the ninth one is nada, which also sounds like the TH, but it's right here spelled N-A-D-A, not N-A-T-H-A, nada. That's what it sounds like, but that's not what it is. It means nothing. So obviously you would understand. So if someone says, like, if someone says, sorry, I just have to look at my list real quick. If someone says, ¿qué haces? Which means, what are you doing? You could say nada, like nothing, I'm not doing anything. So, it's just a matter, and Spanish is, It's actually, I would say, a really easy subject to learn in schools. It's not that difficult, and if it is difficult, it's just you need to pay more, that not to be rude or anything, but it just you need to pay a little bit more attention, because if you really think about it, it's not that hard. Like, literally, if you really, really put your mind, well, it's obviously kind of easy to me because I am half, well, part, half, basically half. I'm basically half Puerto Rican. So, my mom's dad, my grandfather, he's Hispanic. So, I hear Spanish a lot, and I'm just used to it. Like, for instance, my aunt, I don't call her auntie, I call her titi, which means aunt. Or, but that's the thing, I don't call my uncle Theo. I just call him Ian or Tita. I just call him by their first name. But my aunt calls her titi. Like, and my cousin, my aunt's daughter, my titi's daughter, she calls her, my mom, titi. So we just learned from that. We just learned like that, and we've been calling our aunts Titi ever since. So, yeah. But, like, see what I mean? But I grew from it. I've grown from it. Like, it's been with me all my life, so I understand it a lot easier. But hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Hopefully because there wasn't a lot of explaining to do for each of them. I picked pretty easy ones out of my brain because I didn't want to pick hard ones that it would take a long, long time to understand, or like long sentences. Excuse me, sorry. But yes, that is all I have of them. List is looks long, but it's not. It's just I spaced out the writing a lot, so that's why. So thank you guys for watching. Hopefully you guys liked this video. If you did, don't forget to hit that like button. And if you want to see more videos that I will do, please click, well, if you want to get notified when I post more videos, hit the notification bell. And if you are Hispanic, Puerto Rican, Mexican, Spaniard, whatever you are, if you're a Hispanic culture, please comment down below and tell me what culture, and tell me, because I, like I said, I'm Puerto Rican, and tell me a little bit, some tell me how it's different from being Puerto Rican. It's like, if you're Mexican, tell me what's different over there, tell me what's the same over here, you know what I mean? So yeah, just comment down below what I just said. Comment down below. If you're Mexican, you know, Cuban, just comment down below. Like, what's your background? Just comment down below what's your background. So thank you guys so much for watching, and we will see you guys in the next video.